So have you ever heard of the iTunes Visualizer? Well, a lot of you know about it, but some of you may not even know it's there. It's in iTunes on your Mac, and it's been around since the dawn of iTunes. And you can get to it after you start some music. So let's start some music first. And then I'm going to go to View and Visualizer, Show Visualizer, or you can see Command-T brings it up easily. And then it fills the screen with all these graphics that are actually reacting to the music that's being played. Now there are a bunch of different things you can do to customize it. If you use Shift and the question mark key, it brings up some stuff that you can do. You've got M and P for mode change and palette change. So I can keep hitting M and you can see it changes to different modes. If I don't do that, it will eventually cycle through different modes naturally. Also, P will change the palette. It means the colors will come in and change. Now I brings up track info, but there's no info for this particular track that I'm playing, so nothing will show. Now you can also do some toggling. So you can toggle freeze mode. Freeze mode kind of freezes everything in place, but not completely. Things are still moving around a little bit. N turns that nebula on and off in the background. Let's unfreeze that there. Now you can do camera lock, and if I do that, it kind of locks the objects in place somewhat. They still move a little bit. They're just a lot slower. So you can use X and L together to really lock things in place. And then you can kind of see what happens if I unlock the camera and if I unlock the entire thing with unlocking the freeze mode. You can also bring up the frame rate at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen to say how well your Mac's performing with it all. So in general, this is just for a good bit of fun. But you know, if you are using your Mac, your MacBook, or your iMac in the corner of the room and playing some music while you have some people over, consider putting this on rather than letting your Mac go to screensaver or the display shutting off completely, so that there's something to look at. Now, there's another mode entirely. I'll hit the Escape key to get out here. I'll go to Visualizer, and there's Classic Visualizer. Because at some point Apple updated it to make it look like this, and some people still like the classic look. So we'll switch to the classic look and you can go and see that. And now you may recognize this. The classic look always started with that Apple logo there. You also have some things that you can do here. The H key brings up some help there, and actually you can toggle through two different modes of help. So you can see you can toggle some things and have it do some different things for you. In this mode as well as the regular mode. So you can enjoy these. Some people actually like doing screen grabs, Command-Shift-3 and then grabbing a screen and using it for something like, say, a desktop background. But it's just fun to know it's there, and it's a neat thing to have display. You notice another option was to play videos, and if in my playlist there were any music videos as well as just pure audio songs, then the videos would play on the screen. So if you have a mix of music videos and music, you can always have something going on the screen even if what's playing is not a music video at the time. So it's kind of fun. Play around with it and see if you've got a use for it the next time you have friends over and you want to listen to music with your Mac.